Hi everyone, thanks for coming tonight. Before we get started, I would like to acknowledge the traditional owners of the land on which we meet, the Gadigal people of the Eora Nation, and pay my respects to the elders past, present, and emerging. Welcome to Verge Gallery. My name is Tisha Malott, and I'm the director of the space. thanks. This is my first evening gig. And it's really nice to see such a great turnout for such a great show and such an amazing panel of people who are going to be speaking for us tonight. Facilitating the discussion will be Donna West Brett. So I think we should just get started and let's go. So Donna, over to you.
So tonight we're talking about this exhibition called Critical Bodies, but also thinking about the idea of critical bodies in terms of some of the things that are raised with these artworks. As most of you know, and artists definitely know, artists are always at the forefront of everything. Art historians and theorists follow. So it's great to kind of see artists doing such really fantastic and engaging work. So tonight we are joined by some of the artists in the exhibition and also the curators. So we have Danica Knezevic, right here.
Hello.
David Collins.
Hey.
Cherine Fahd, who is one of the curators. Natalya Hughes, who is here as an external commentator and specialist in her field. And of course, Julie Rrap, who is also one of the curators. So welcome everybody.
Thanks, guys.
So I'm sure you've all seen the exhibition, and we're going to be talking a little bit first about this idea of fragility that comes through so many of the works in terms of the body as exposed, the body in terms of gender, the body in terms of sexuality, in terms of strength and weakness. There's quite a lot really that play out here. So I'm going to open up a broad question to our wonderful panel. In terms of something we've been talking about, I was talking to Cherine about earlier, in terms of Judith Butler. And Judith Butler talks about this idea of the vulnerable body in terms of how this, I don't know if you can hear over this video behind me, in terms of the resistance that comes out of, or the vulnerability that it comes out of resistance in terms of politics, in terms of gender fluidity, all sorts of various things. So one of the things that Judith Butler talks about is that one of the truest forms of resistance is in fact one in which vulnerable bodies are exposed in solidarity. And we see that particularly last year in terms of the same-sex marriage debate, this idea of this fragility and vulnerability of an entire community, and of course their loved ones. So there is something that's kind of in the air, particularly I think at the moment in terms of this, and of course Judith Butler also talks about it in terms of protest. We are all becoming active citizens, and in that activity and in that resistance, we are actually quite vulnerable. So I just wanted to open it up to the panel to talk about either some of the ideas behind the exhibition and also the works in terms of how you see vulnerability playing out here. And maybe we'll start with you, Danica, if you don't mind. Just in terms of your work, which I'm a huge fan, as you know, in terms of this idea of putting your body under stress, under a vulnerability, but also in terms of thinking about, this relationship with your mother and vulnerability there in terms of a fragile body. And in fact, we can see that in some of the works, other works around us.
Mm-hmm. And when you spoke about protest and how we understand, the first thing I thought of in terms of Judith Butler and active in public space as protest is the work I had over there, which is Summer. And it's of my mum's, back then, 2012 or 2014, it was her wheelchair, and it's underneath, and you can see Bondi Beach. So it's just within reach, but you can't actually get there. So mum's in a wheelchair, she's got polio, she had from birth, and so the depths of vulnerability is that you want to go to the beach and you've got these set of stairs and you can't actually get there. But nonetheless, you occupy this space. In terms of vulnerability and art in question of using the body within performance, when I use my own body as opposed to my family member's body, it is not necessarily about vulnerability, but it is how, as a woman, we negotiate the weight of what we are feeling or what we entail. And that's, to be honest, relatable. Despite what gender you are or who you are, it is about carrying weight, being susceptible to vulnerability, but knowing that ultimately you're going to get through this. You have to carry on, hold it, and move past that.
And I think it's quite evident in this work and the one in the hallway, but also that other wonderful work that which I've seen in the video work, where you're actually lifting the history of your own family in terms of photographs, and you know how terrified I was every time one of those books dropped. I'm like, going, oh my God.
What's really important is to know that we all have certain amounts of weight, and we all carry that.
Yeah.
It doesn't matter how much you can lift at the gym. We all carry a certain amount of weight.
Like numb.
And that doesn't matter, but every day we do carry things. And as a society, you brought up Judith Butler in terms of this idea that we're all active civilians in a protest. We're all carrying this weight of the world.
Yeah.
But we're all having to kind of manage that in a way that we go, okay, well, I just need to earn that dollar so that I can pay my own rent as well. You know, it's a layered conversation.
Yep. And David, you might want to talk about your work in terms of this idea of fragility, but also of marking the body, but also this work that you do with animals and how that kind of comes about.
I guess working with the animal for me was sort of a way of trying to find an analogue for finding a reality to that vulnerability, and especially in our own heads, and particularly as men, where you've told you're strong and indestructible and everything, to sort of try and find that pivot point place where the animal sort of acts as an analogue for, the larger sublime or something unpredictable, and try and find a place where I'm creating that collaboration with the animal where genuinely that power that I'd sort of assumed over the animal suddenly becomes at risk, where I'm not in control anymore and suddenly realise that I am just, this body that's sort of in contact with something that I can have this dialogue with through sort of trying to read its cues and stuff, but at the end of the day, when I'm in its territory or sort of had my power shifted by being in an uncomfortable situation, it also has a certain amount of say.
Yeah, and I love this work here where basically the octopus is it octopus or squid?
It's an octopus, yeah.
it ends up marking you,
yeah, absolutely.
Along with, you've already got these tattoos. And now the octopus is also kind of marking you in this way, which is quite sensual.
Yeah.
But also, I don't think they're that dangerous, but they do get quite close to some parts that you don't particularly want damaged.
Yeah.
So, it's kind of like, get that octopus away. No, it's really quite mesmerising.
Well, I mean, a few people have asked, to justify the nudity in the work, and I did consider doing it, sort of like with a bathing suit or something on, but I thought I did need to be where I was genuinely uncomfortable,
yeah.
and that was the part that I was worried about. Like,
yeah.
they've got beaks and,
I
needed to be in a place where sort of I was uncomfortable, and that was
yeah.
the best way to do that.
Yeah, and it's really fascinating how the viewer really engages with it on that level.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's great. Thank you very much. And the horsework is just divine.
Thank you.
So beautiful. We might open it up to the curators and also to our guest, Natalya. Perhaps Julie and Cherine, you could talk about some of the ideas behind the exhibition and really what kind of stimulated this whole really beautiful show coming about.
Well, perhaps I should say something. It's interesting because Critical Bodies is actually a title I've been sort of rolling with for years, but in the teaching space. So when I used to teach at University of Western Sydney, that was when I created this elective called Critical Bodies. And it actually looked at film a lot more and things like that. So I sort of, as you do, I kind of rolled it over to Sydney College of the Arts. And, that's kind of the origin of it. But I always thought it's an interesting title, Cherine and I talked about and we rolled it around together, because you can sort of think of the body, it is obviously critical to us, but it's also something that can be critical of things. So I think it sort of plays out in a whole lot of different directions. And so I guess it sort of started with that discussion and that title. And in fact, there's still an elective running at Sydney College of the Arts called Critical Bodies, which sort of rolls a bit more into performance now and so on. So it's had this kind of long history where it keeps changing. But, you know, I mean, the body's like this, you know, if you think about the history of art, the body's kind of
it's an endless subject.
I mean, it's, I keep thinking of this, this has been Julie and my love project, where we would, you know, for 5.5 years stood in the corridors of photo media at SCA and looked at amazing work, and always felt that it was a shame that it wasn't going to be seen outside of that teaching space. So finally we kind of got it together to kind of put this exhibition, put a proposal out for the exhibition. So in a way it is a very, I feel like it's a very special thing. It's quite generative to be an academic, but to also be an artist, and to be an artist who curates other artists. It's been really quite beautiful. And I think the other thing in taking Donna through the show earlier, and also on Monday I had 50 first year UTS students in here, and actually being able to talk about all the work in the show quite intimately as though it were my own. And I realised that when you work with students, you actually have this incredible connection to your students' work as though it were your own. And you know it as though it were your own. You don't kind of have that distance. It had not occurred to me until I'd started talking about the work on Monday.
And there's also a couple of things you mentioned, particularly in terms of intimacy, that really is quite another very strong theme through this work. And Natalya, would you perhaps like to comment on your opinion of the work, but also on this idea of intimacy and how you read it perhaps in some of these ways?
I guess it's the other part of vulnerability to some extent.
Yes, yes.
Because for me, the vulnerability is about being a kind of instability of categories in some ways, about gender or different ways in which we name the body, but it also being a vulnerability that comes from an instability of just the nature of the body itself. Just the instability of I, because I think about the body having featured in art history for a very long time and certain classical traditions, and then those that fight against it. And I think about the long-term association of particular rewritings of the body as part of the avant-garde. And it seems to me that over and over again, what's at stake is the body, but frequently who has authored that avant-garde body representation has not been the body that's featured. But in these works, there's something different happening because many of the artists here have authored this particular vulnerability, claimed it, re-represented it, and that's quite significant.
Yes, exactly.
The artists themselves have chosen a kind of reinvention, and as per Judith Butler's thing, it's a vulnerability chosen in order to demonstrate something political of their own, and I think that makes these very significant practices and very tender practices.
Yes, yeah, exactly. I mean, it's interesting, as you've all mentioned, art history in terms of the body and the classical and various other things. And of course, what you'll find in this exhibition is, in contemporary art, are artists putting the other back into art history. So there is a very, bizarrely enough, Beyoncé and Jay-Z's, own latest video in the Louvre is about placing the black body into the Western hegemony of a major art museum. So there is actually quite active participation and active agency that artists are engaging with in order to actually put these different bodies into art history. And of course the gay body, the queer body is of course one of those bodies that is has been not even largely absent, it's been there, but it's been erased. So there's a lot of erasure and absence in art history that I think a lot of artists now are actually trying to address. And interestingly enough, looking at David's work, of course, a lot of your work is derived or inspired by some very well-known classical, but also not so well-known classical paintings, sculpture, various other things. Would you like to briefly talk about that?
Well, I guess apart from the fact that part of the reason that I'm inspired by that work is because I genuinely find it beautiful and attractive and interesting and inspiring. It's also because I think that's the sort of art that it's a shorthand for us to start a dialogue. There's already a language there that exists that we sort of think we understand, and then by subverting that, by just changing it slightly, like you mentioned, by changing the dialogue or the connotations, by shifting the way the bodies interact with each other. I mean, we've got so many tools that these artists didn't have. We've got video, so we can tell a narrative through through action rather than just depicted sequence.
And media is actually quite important in terms of opening up access. So even in the 60s, it was video art that women engaged with because it was accessible and they could actually use it as a vehicle for a dialogue. So yes, and you're doing it in terms of the past art history and quite significant kind of works that your work relates to. So yes, it's quite fascinating actually, really beautiful, thank you. And thank you to the artists who actually came tonight and to our great panel, so Danica, who's just going to get some air, Julie, Natalya, Cherine, and David.
And so thank you.